Well done, Ross. In a moment now, Ross, I'm going to click my fingers, and when I click my fingers, you're going to find that you will be able to cross this bridge. But not until I click my fingers will you even want to cross this bridge. You'll also find that with every step that you take on this bridge, it will take you further and further back in time. Back in time when you lived on this earth in the past. Back in time when your spirit roamed this earth a long, long time ago. But what I want you to do, Ross, is I want you to go and find a time and a place where you knew that you was happy, safe, secure, and where no harm could come to you. And when you get there, I'm going to be asking you questions. You'll also find that you will be able to answer all my questions with ease and in your own voice. So here we go now. I'm going to click my fingers, and every step you take on this bridge will take you further and further back in time. Back in time when you lived on this earth in the past. When you were safe and happy, and where no harm could come to you. And you will find it's easy to talk to me, to answer all my questions. So let's go. Now. Over you go, Ross, go on. Can you tell me, is it light or is it dark now?
Right.
It's light, okay. So where would you be then, do you think? Do you think you'd be inside or outside?
Outside.
So it's light and you're outside. And do you feel safe here?
Yes.
Is it okay to go for a walk here then?
Yes.
Go on then. So it's light and you're outside and you feel safe. And what does the ground feel like then? Does that feel as though it's hard or soft?
Hard, but it's the grass not around, but it's hard, the ground, the path.
Okay. Have a look down at your feet while you're walking on this hard ground with the grass around. What are you wearing on your feet now?
Red shoes.
Red shoes?
Yeah, I think high heels, I believe. Yeah.
Working your way up from your shoes then, what else would you be wearing?
It's a long flowing dress. Mm-hmm. And it's sort of like light colour, and it's sort of like, it's got different layers and sort of frilly.
That's okay, don't worry.
I know what it is to see, but
yeah.
I don't know what they call it.
Well, you know what it looks like, you're wearing it.
It's a hat and top. So.
Mm-hmm. Mm. So, can you tell me, do you feel as though you're big or small now?
Actually fairly tall. For
yeah? Yeah. If you give yourself an age then, what would it be, do you think?
An age?
How old would you be, do you think?
30. I'm sort of 6 or 7. Mid-30s.
Mid-30s?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. 36, I go for.
Okay. Yeah.
Actually looks longer, but for some reason, she's.
So I just go with the first thing that you said. That's fine. Yeah. Sometimes people look younger than they really are, don't they? Yeah. And so here you are. You're walking on this ground and wearing your red shoes and your lovely dress. So have a look around you. Tell me what else is here.
I think it's a bit big ground, but I think I can see. Is it horse and carriage coming up? Up something? Yeah, I do. I think I do. And it's a great big house as well. Massive garden and sort of like, you know, like a bit of grass and path coming through. And then it's a lake.
Are you walking towards the house now or the lake?
Both, really. The house is to my right, and the lake's kind of to my left.
So this house, is this where you live, do you think, or are you just visiting?
I'm not visiting. I'm not so. I don't know, like the role. No, that's not. I do. Yeah, I could reside here. Pretty sure.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm not sure what capacity. But it's definitely. I spent a lot of time here, I think.
If I asked you what your first name was now, what would you say?
Jane.
Jane?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is there anybody else here with you, Jane?
No, I think there's people in the distance coming up. I was alone when I was walking.
Yeah? And yet you're walking towards these people?
Trying to get focus.
Are they dressed similar to you?
Yes. So do you want more information?
It's okay, I'm just waiting for the people to get to you.
Alright. So there's 2 miles here in the distance, supposed to there's a house, and I could have went either way. I'll go up.
Let's go where all the people are.
Yeah.
Let's go see what they're doing.
Okay. Just talking, there's like a car, a black car, and they're sort of standing outside. And I see a man with a cane. And he's a big, it's got grey hair, it's got old, and he's got a big top hat.
Is he?
Yeah. Really, it's very black, and it's a black suit. And he's got.
Do you know him? Who would he be, do you think? Is he related to you?
I don't think so, actually. For some reason I hear the word George, for some reason. He's about a gentleman. I'm struggling a bit.
So if I ask you what year it was now then, Jane, what would you say? What would the first 2 numbers be, do you think? 'Cause this is, if you're not sure, don't worry.
Don't know, I think it's because I was thinking too much about it. I think it's, for some reason I'm thinking 1806 for some reason. At first I was in 17 and I wasn't sure and I jumped.
It's because you walked the other way, didn't you?
No, because I was trying to think, my conscious mind was thinking too much about what time it would be.
Don't let your conscious mind interfere, just allow things just to come and go as they want.
I'm not really. I don't know.
Do you remember where the house was?
Yeah, I'm still quite close to it.
Yeah, let's go into the house then.
Yeah. yeah.
Who else lives in this house with you? Well, you said you were 36, Jane. Are you married?
Yes.
Where would your husband be? Is he in the house?
There's a lot of people in. There's actually a lot of people in this house.
Is there?
Yeah. I can always see people like to my left already.
What are they doing?
They're having tea, actually. So, I believe, for some reason, I believe he's not actually isn't in the house. I believe I can see a car coming up. I think there's a car coming up now towards the house. So I don't think he's there at the moment. So what else I want to know? It's massive. It's got big steps.
There's somebody coming up the steps now.
No one, well, I don't think so. I think it's just only me if I want. I can see a man somewhere. I'm now a bit lost, but I can see a man who's got a call. You know, I've got that's a big something like a rig type thing, like, sort of grey. Look at men, they've got that. I don't know how it's grown, they've got that big sort of like hair, like, you know, like the sort of, yeah, I know what I mean by this guy. I'm not sure where I am at the moment. I'm sort of.
So, this house, does it have a name?
Is it Mansfield for some reason? I can see a big golden gate actually. I've sort of reverted back to the beginning again. So it's like a gate, it's a very big golden gate, and it's sort of. I can't describe it, it's like a little. I know what it looks like. What do you expect, actually? It's just golden, it's supposed to be.
Yeah. Do you have anything on the gate? Is there?
And it's a sort of shapes and there's like a little motif in, but it's hard for me to describe them. I'm not sure what to call them.
Is there a name on the gate or a crest or anything like that?
Second. I see a lot of gold. I can't see a lot of.
That's okay. So earlier, when I asked you the name of the house, you said Mansfield, didn't you?
Yeah.
What I want you to do is I want you to go and find somebody. Maybe somebody important. Maybe your husband or that elderly man called George. And I want you to go and ask them what they call this place. And because. They're wise and they know these things, they'll tell you.
For some reason I'm not. Sounds like a weird name, but for some reason, I'm not feeling.
Just say as they said.
It's weird. It's like, sounds like Hudson de Manor or something like that.
Hudson de Manor?
No, Hudsland Manor.
Okay.
I don't know. I just. Something popped. I don't know why. I'm just going by water. So it seems random. And I suppose after I hear something, I just. Yeah, okay. Go for that.
Yeah, okay.
Interesting.
So then, Jane, what do you call your husband? He calls you Jane, but what do you call him?
James.
Jane and James?
Yeah.
That's nice. That's,
yeah, it's very... Yeah.
And when you married him, you took his name as well, didn't you? You took his last name. This house, is it your house or his house?
His.
It must be very important to have such a big house. It's why is he important, do you think?
Okay, I keep seeing the word royalty, so I'm going to have to go for that.
Okay. So does he have a title?
Yeah, Lord.
So you'd be a lady then?
Yes, I believe.
And so when you married him, you took his last name, didn't you? So you would be called Lady Jane?
Funny man, name.
What's it sound like?
Ransroth.
Mansroth.
No, Rand. Roth. Wrt. That's a funny sound name. I don't know if that's right.
Mm-hmm. That's okay. That's
I don't know if it's going not coming up through right, but. Someone very visual, so when it comes to like words and details, I think sometimes.
What about children? Do you have any children?
I've just seen some. Another said that. Like a little boy, and a little girl. No, this is somebody's picked up the little girl, and the little boy's just sort of running around.
Who would George be, do you think? The old man with the cane.
Yes, that's a silver. He's not butler, he's not quite like he's more kinda, I don't know if gatekeeper is perhaps a better term for him. He's more kind of like a overseer, yeah, or somebody that's what I think. But someone I trust, I believe.
Okay. Is it okay to go back outside now, Jane?
Yeah.
Let's go back outside. Okay. Go for a walk down there towards the lake. Just down there is where the bridge is. Do you remember that nice bridge?
Yeah.
It's only down there, Jane. Let's go down there to the bridge. When you get to the bridge, I want you to let me know.
Yeah.
Good, well done. In a moment now, Jane, I'm going to click my fingers. And when I click my fingers, you're going to find that you can go over this bridge. It's all right for you to do so. You won't get into trouble or anything. And as you go over this bridge, what I want you to do, Jane, is I want you to leave behind here any unwanted thoughts, feelings or emotions. You are not allowed to bring them over this bridge with you. And if you do try to bring them with you, you'll find it's really hard. And the more you try, the harder it becomes. The harder it becomes, the more you try. So by the time you get all the way over to the other side, you'll have found it's impossible. So let's go. Now. Over you go, Jane. Go on. Over the bridge. letting go of all those unwanted thoughts, feelings and emotions now. Just letting them drift back in time where they belong. Getting closer and closer to me now, Ross. Getting bigger and stronger. Closer and closer to me now. Coming off the bridge now. Back down onto the path. Feeling calm and relaxed. Calm and relaxed. And in a moment now, Ross, I'm going to click my fingers again. And when I click my fingers again, I want you to go back over this bridge. And what I want you to do is I want you to go to a totally different time and to a totally different place to where you've just been. A time and a place that was way, way beyond where you've just been. Further and further back in time. You'll find you can do this very quickly, just a few steps over this bridge. We'll take you to that totally different time and to that totally different place to where you've just been. But again, you can only go to a time and a place where you felt happy and safe and where no harm could come to you. And just like before, you'll find it's easy to talk to me. Only this time the answers will come a lot quicker to you. It'll be a lot clearer. So here we go. Now. Over you go, Ross. Go on. Tell me where you are now. Are you inside or outside?
Outside again. Yeah.
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 What are you doing?
I'm on a horse. I think. Yeah.
Now you're going slow or quick?
Moderate pace. I'm not going hurry.
So you're just walking along the horse?
Yeah, I'm someone, yeah.
Yeah? Colour horse have you got?
It's white.
A white one?
Yeah.
Is anybody else here with you?
Some people nearby, actually.
Yeah? Are they riding horses?
Not all of them.
No. What about you? Have a look down at yourself while you're riding the horse. Tell me what you're wearing now.
It's kind of... Well, it's funny sort of that it's like a knight, but it's more like... I don't know if it's Roman, I'm not sure, like... You know, like a helmet. I had like a helmet. I'm just taking it off. I'm holding it now. And it's sort of like metal armor, and then that was sort of like a, what do you call it? It's like a sort of, you know, like
chainmail.
That normal top over the legs. It's not. It's like a sort of a. I'm not sure how to call it. It's not a kilt, but I'm trying to get that direction because I'm trying to describe what it is. It's sort of a Roman dress, and it's sort of very, yeah.
Roman. Is that a man or a woman?
A man, that's the definitely.
Yeah.
Yes.
And are you clean shaven, or do you have a mustache or a beard?
I think I'm blonde here.
So you're on your horse, just going along slowly. Have a look around you then, what's here? Are there buildings here, or fields, or trees, or what's here?
It's a castle in the distance, but it's quite a fair way. There's a path, and I think you can see a river. Newman Brent and some shrubs, and there's some people to my right. There's seen this tents and there's horse and horses as well, and I don't know, I might be building something, I'm not sure.
Do you feel as though you're important? On your white horse?
Yeah, I mean... In my own way, I'm not sure that necessarily as important as I was as high up as I was last time, I've definitely got my own... There's different levels of importance, aren't there? Because... definitely significant. Definitely.
You said that you're wearing armour and things like that.
Yeah.
Not everybody can afford armour, so you must be a well-to-do person if you've got armour.
Yeah, but I'm a knight, so.
Do you have any weapons?
I have a sword, and I believe I've got. Yeah, I have a sword and shield, and no. For some reason I can see some arrows as well, I don't know, that's unusual, but I can see some, a pouch and some arrows and
yeah.
Bow, so I've got that as well.
Okay. And what are you doing here? Why are you here?
I don't know, is it if you're preparing for something or... building something or establishing something, as if like I'm building a village, I believe that might be actually what that is. As if you sort of expanding or this sort of as if you're setting or something.
And what do I call you now?
I seem to would Frederick or Federico or Frederick or something. Frederick, I think. Because I'm in Britain, because I said Roman, so I don't think I'm in.
Where would you be then? Which country are you in, do you think?
Italy, I think. I believe.
You said earlier that you were building a village, extending the village. What do they call the village?
What are they calling it? Oh.
What's its name?
It's not... I think it was just the early... I think it did this... Well, this starting that up, so I don't know if I've... I'm not sure if they've got a name then. I don't know. For some reason I've got the word Alexandria, for some reason. I'm not sure about these words, I can't remember, but I have to go along.
What year would it be now then, Frederick? What would the first two numbers be, do you think?
I'm seeing 14. So, mm-hmm.
Again. What about the last two then? What would they be?
I don't know, actually 1492, so I'm going to have to go. Again, I'm not sure if that's...
That's alright, don't worry.
But I'm just going to go.
It's the first thing that comes into your head, that's what's important, isn't it?
Yeah. You can think too much about that, can't you?
Yeah.
Because I think, is that actually, you think, is that... I suppose I can find that out, yeah.
Do you have a last name, Frederick?
Yeah, but I've got my friend. I don't know if I can pronounce it.
Can you spell it?
I think it begins with L. Something like the Mario or the Mario or something like that.
Okay. Well, it's been nice talking to you, Frederick, but it's time for me to go now. But for me to go, I need to go to where the bridge is. Would it take me there?
Yeah.
When we get to the bridge, will you let me know?
Yeah.
Thank you. In a moment now, Frederick, I'm going to click my fingers. When I click my fingers, I want you to go over the bridge with me. It's okay for you to do so. And again, what I want you to do is I want you to leave behind here any unwanted thoughts, feelings and emotions, as you're not allowed to bring them over that bridge with you. So let's go now. Over you go now. Just letting go of all unwanted thoughts, feelings and emotions now. Just letting them drift back in time where they belong. Coming further and further over the bridge now. Coming all the way over now, Ross. Back down onto the other side. Feeling totally calm and relaxed again now. Totally calm and relaxed. Do you remember where the bench was? Yes, go and sit back down on the bench for me then.
Can I get my feet in the ground? Good.
Relax now, calm. That's it, totally relaxed and calm now. In a moment now, Ross. I'm going to count from 1 to 5. And when I get to 5, you're going to find that you'll be able to open your eyes. You're going to be back in the here and now. But not until I get to 5 will you even want to open your eyes. But when you do open your eyes, you're going to find that you are totally awake, totally alert, feeling refreshed, feeling full of life and full of energy, feeling absolutely fantastic. And these feelings will stay with you for as long as you want them to. So here we go now. 1, starting to wake now. 2, getting lighter and brighter. 3, all the sounds around you getting louder and louder. 4 and 5. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Good, well done. Well done.